Today, we will be having a showdown to see if these Atlas Copco screwdrivers can maintain an accuracy of plus or minus 10% when used on both hard joints and soft joints. This EBL screwdriver uses a clutch to control the torque output, while this ETD MicroTorque screwdriver uses a transducer. We will be testing these screwdrivers using these hard and soft joint simulators on this Atlas Copco stationary transducer. We will start off by running the transducerized screwdriver on this soft joint for 5 rundowns. Soft joints are very common in assemblies. Factors like the softness of the material used and hardware such as washers increase the amount of rotation it takes to reach the final torque once the fastener is fully seated. The transducerized screwdriver was able to maintain an average deviation of only 3.43%. It passed the first test. The second test is the hard joint. Hard joints are less common than soft joints and are defined by having very minimal rotation to reach the final torque once the fastener is fully seated. Since the transducer in the tool is constantly monitoring the torque output, it can quickly shut off once it nears our desired value of 10 cm. Our deviation is even better on the hard joint at only negative 0.68%, another pass. Let's run the same tests on this clutch tool now. A clutch tool isn't a smart tool, so we can't program it to react to changes in the joint. Instead, it relies solely on the tension of the spring to engage the clutch when enough torque is detected. We will set the torque on this tool using a soft joint as reference. As expected, the clutch tool did well on the soft joint, staying within an average of 2.84% of its target torque. The hard joint test will now show the weaknesses of a standard clutch screwdriver. Since a hard joint goes from being seated to fully torqued in a minimal amount of rotation, the clutch tool can't anticipate the shutoff fast enough. This is causing the tool to overshoot our torque goal and over-tighten the joint. The data shows that our deviation is at negative 25.08% over 5 runs, which fails by the criteria we set earlier. Comparison of the torque traces shows how the transducer tool quickly and cleanly shuts off, where the clutch tool has a more rounded shutoff and noisy disengagement. The hard joint graph shows the real difference. The transducer tool is able to use its smart programming to anticipate the shutoff, whereas the clutch tool is caught off guard and overshoots the target. It's important to understand the dynamics of a joint that you are fastening, especially when they are critical to safety or reliability in a product. You leave a lot of things up to chance when using a clutch tool. If you are interested in getting more traceability and improving your assembly processes, contact us today at the link in the description. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to catch the next video from Flexible Assembly Systems.